Good morning, friends. I am Dr. Pradeep Singh, Associate Professor of Pharmacognosy in Faculty of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Rama University, Kanpur, Uttar Pradesh. Since I am a man of pharmacognosy and I am dealing with the subject pharmacognosy, so I would like to start from the introduction. Pharmacognosy. It is derived from two Greek words, pharmakon and gignosko. Pharmakon means a drug and gignosko means to acquire knowledge of. So pharmacognosy is science or knowledge of crude drugs. Now the proper definition of pharmacognosy. We can define the term pharmacognosy at it may be defined as a branch of bioscience which treats in detail of medicinal and related products of crude and primary type obtained from plants, animals, minerals and marine sources. So this is a proper definition of pharmacognosy. Now the term pharmacognosy is coined by John Adam Smith in 1811. Actually there is a misinformation and confusion between John Adam Smith and C.A. Sidler. Some sources gave the credit to C.A. Sidler, but John Adam Smith is an actual person who coined the term in 1811 in his book Leherbach Der Materia Medica. In this book, he describes the medicinal plant and their properties, and it was published in Vienna. Now, C.A. Sidler, he was a German medical student and he has written a book, his doctoral thesis, Analecta Pharmacognostica, and it was published in 1815. So, actual credit goes to John Adam Smith for the term pharmacognosy. So, being a pharmacognosist, it is a role to prepare monograph of crude drugs which are of medicinal importance. So, to prepare monograph, we have to compile the monograph in these points. We will start from name of drug. Here we will use the name of drug which is given in official books, publications, journals, then synonyms. Here we will use various synonyms, various biological source of the various botanical names of the drug. Third point is biological source. Biological source is composed of the exact plant part which is of medicinal importance along with botanical or biological name which is composed of genus and species and then family. The third point is geographical source, distribution or habitat. This point covers the distribution, the habitat from where we can obtain crude drug, we can maintain the supply of crude drug to herbal industry to get to collect the drug in proper time. Then morphological, microscopical characters or description. Here we will discuss, we will give some morphological characters by which we can identify the drug with the use of our naked eye. The morphological characters are also called microscopical character and description. Now the third next point is microscopical character. Here we will discuss various cellular and tissues arrangement of the drug to confirm the proper identification of a drug. In this case, mostly we are studying transverse section and longitudinal section and various cell constituents like palisade ratio, stomatal index, stomatal number. Then next is chemical constituent. Chemical constituent is most important parameter of the monograph. Here we are using, yeah, we are writing the chief active constituent of a drug which is mainly responsible for the pharmacological property, like cinchona. Cinchona is a medicinal plant which is used in malaria, and the chief active constituent which is responsible for anti-malarial activity is quinine. So we will write in the monograph of cinchona in chemical constituent quinine. Another component of the same drug cinchona is quinidine, which is antidepressant, which is cardiac depressant, which is used in cardiac arrhythmia. So in this point chemical constituent we are using, key or chief active constituent of the drug which is responsible for particular pharmacological or medicinal property. Then identification test, here we gives various identification tests to confirm the various various phytochemical categories of the drug like alkaloids, glycosides, tannins, resins. Next is medicinal uses. Here in this subject we are using we are studying medicinal plant, or medicinal plant means those plants which are of medicinal importance. So in the second last point we are giving various medicinal uses of the drug. And the last one is adulterant. Adulterant are similar looking drugs which are lacking the main pharmacological activity. So we will give various allied drugs which are used on behalf of drug, or which are admixed with the main drug. Pharmacognosy plays a paramount role in the field of pharmaceutical science. The key applications of pharmacognosy are knowledge of crude drug from natural origin. The subject gives knowledge of crude drug from the natural origin. In 18th century, all the drugs were from natural origin. In 19th century, some of the drugs were isolated from plants like morphine. It was isolated from papaver somniferum. Quinine, it was from Cinchona calicea, Cinchona ligeriana, Cinchona officinalis, and imatin, strychnine. So these were some important drugs which were isolated from plants. Next application is cultivation techniques of medicinal plant. The subject gives proper cultivation technique of medicinal plant, and which is very important for the maintenance of smooth supply of drug to herbal industry, and which should be of a very good quality in the manner to confirm the presence of higher content of secondary metabolite. Then the subject plays important role in investigation of biosynthetic pathways for primary and secondary metabolites. Secondary metabolites are mostly responsible for medicinal properties, colors, nutritional values, and so on. Then pharmaceutical industry, in the subject, plays a very important role for the development of herbal formulations. Then it is a very important for standardization of crude drugs. Crude drugs should be of good quality, which are used in preparation of herbal formulations. Then the subject plays a very important role to prepare an analyst which is serving for food and drug analysis. And then the subject is very important for forensic science. So next topic is classification of crude drugs. We can classify crude drugs in various methods to study their characters. First one is alphabetical classification. In this we are organizing drugs according to their alphabets, according to alphabet of their names. Second is taxonomical classification. It is a most accurate classification, and it is based on the evolutionary character of a drug, like from kingdom to species: kingdom, subkingdom, order, suborder, class, subclass, family, genus, and then species. So it is a most accurate and most scientific classification. Next is morphological classification. This classification is further divided into two parts: organized and unorganized. Organized drugs are those which are having a proper cellular structure, proper tissues arrangement. And in this category, we are classifying drugs according to their plant part, like leaves, stem, flower, root, fruit, and so on. In case of unorganized drug, here there is no any proper cellular arrangement, there is no any proper tissue arrangement, and in this we are organizing drugs like wax, resins, gums, extracts, and so on. Next is pharmacological and therapeutic classification. It is another most important classification of this subject, because it is based on pharmacological property or therapeutic effect or medicinal use of the drug. Here we are classifying drugs according to their medicinal properties, like anti-diabetic, anti-cancer, anti-inflammatory, anti-ulcer. But the problem of this classification is that a particular drug can be comes under two or three or four different categories, as the same drug is used for so many pharmacological effects, like cinchona. Cinchona is having anti-malarial property because of quinine, so it will come under anti-malarial drugs. The same drug cinchona contains quinidine. Quinidine is responsible for cardiac depressant activity. So the same drug cinchona also comes under cardiac depressant. So this is the problem of this of pharmacological or therapeutic classification. And the last one is chemical and biogenetic classification. Here we are classifying drugs according to their phytochemical categories, like alkaloids, glycosides, tannins, resins. And in case of biogenetic classification, we are classifying drugs according to their biosynthetic or biogenetic pathway, like tyrosine. The drugs obtained are biosynthesized from tyrosine, tryptophan, phenylalanine, or some other pathways. Now we will discuss antihypertensive category of drugs. Antihypertensive drugs are those drugs which are used to reduce elevated blood pressure to normal level. Some drugs are used in this category are Rolfia serpentina, Equorus calamus, and Allium satyrum lassun. So now we will discuss first drug. It is Rolfia. Common name of names of Rolfia in Hindi are Sarpgandha and Chandrika. In Sanskrit, the drug is called Chota Chan. In English, it is called Serpentina and Snake Root. Snake root, because of its appearance, is its morphology. Biological source. The drug is obtained from dried roots of the plant Rolfia serpentina, belonging to family Apocynaceae. Morphology of the drug is, color of the drug is pale brown, odor is odorless, and taste is bitter. Chief active constituents, the drug contains approximate 1.5 to 3% of the alkaloids, and main alkaloids are reserpine, serpentine, esmeline, and so many other alkaloids are also reported from the drug. Reserpine is mainly responsible for antihypertensive activity. Uses, as the comes under category of antihypertensive, so it is used in antihypertensive. Others are hypnotic, sedative, and bitter tonic. Two allied drugs are used in place of Rolfia are Rolfia density flora and Rolfia paracensis. These two drugs are devoid of reserpines, means reserpine content is absent, reserpine content is nil in these two drugs. But these are allied species of Rolfia serpentina, and because of its morphological similarity, the drug is admixed with the main drug. Now we will discuss next category of drug, antidiabetic drugs. Antidiabetic drugs are those drugs which are used to reduce elevated blood glucose level in diabetic patients. Some of the drugs which are commonly used as a antidiabetic are terocorpus, it is called Vijayasar, Jibnema, it is Gurmar, Sizium, Jamun, Mamordica, it is Karela, and Morus Elba, Sehtut. So now we will discuss first drug, that is Jibnema. Jibnema, common name of the drug are, in Hindi it is called Gurmar, Sanskrit it is Madhu Nasini, English it is Ram's Horn. Biological source of the drug is obtained from leaves, dried as well as fresh, of the plant Jibnema sylvestri, belonging to family Asclepiaceae. Chemical constituents, mostly all category of phytoconstituents are obtained from the drug, like glycosides, alkaloids, flavones, resins. But chief active constituent or anti-diabetic activity is because of jibnemic acid. This jibnemic acid is responsible for anti-hyper glycemic effect. Now the use, the drug is used in to cure diabetes, to reduce obesity, to treat anemia, to reduce blood blood cholesterol level as hypolipidemic drug, and in arthritis. Next drug of anti-diabetic category is pterocarpus, common name in Hindi it is called Vijayasar or Kashtha, Sanskrit it is Sarfaka or Pitasar, in English it is Indian Kinowood. Biological source, the drug is obtained from dried juice of heartwood of the plant Pterocarpus marsupium belonging to family Fabaceae, and this family Fabaceae comes under Leguminosy. Chemical constituent, pterosupine is responsible for antidiabetic activity along with quinotannic acid, quinoin. Uses, the drug is very good remedy for treatment of diabetes, and a formulation is available in market is Pramehagna. Other uses of drugs are blood purifier, astringent, and toothache. Now we will discuss next category of drugs, anti-malarial. Cinchona and Artemisia annua are most common drugs which are used to treat malaria. Now we will discuss cinchona. Common name of the drug in Hindi it is quinina, in Sanskrit it is kunayaka, in English it is Jesuit's bark and Peruvian bark. Biological source, the drug is obtained from dried bark of the plant cinchona. Four different species of cinchona are used to isolate various anti-malarial constituent various constituent of cinchona. These are cinchona calicia, cinchona saxirubra, cinchona ligeriana, and cinchona officinalis belonging to family Rubiaceae. Chemical constituents, four important chemical constituents have been isolated from the drug along with so many other alkaloids. The important alkaloids, important chemical constituents are quinine, quinidine, cinchonine, and cinchonidine. Quinine and quinidine are stereoisomer of each other. Their molecular formula are same, but they are stereoisomer of each other, and this leads to huge change in pharmacological activity. Quinine is used as anti-malarial drug, while quinidine is used for cardiac depressant in case of arrhythmia. Quinine is a most popular drug. It was first extracted and isolated from cinchona in 1820, and in 1864 it comes in commercial use. Now in 20th century, that is in 1944, it was synthesized in laboratory, and now it is available as a synthetic salt. Uses, the drug is used to treat malaria, bitter tonic, arrhythmia, and antiseptic drug. So my dear students, today we have discussed introduction of pharmacognosy along with scope, classification, and we have discussed some category of some pharmacological category of drugs like anti-diabetic, anti-malarial, anti-hypertensive. Now in the next lecture we will discuss some other category of drugs. Thank you.